old student. And speaking of the subject, I thirst, look at that, I thirst. And he put the vinegar in the sponge and put it up to his mouth. Let me clear my throat. It looks like a simple word on the surface, but the implications are deep and abiding to our theological reflections about our Lord Christ and the message that he sends to us about the practical aspects of the Christian faith on a daily basis. In other words, what we're seeing extended on the cross today through these seven words, and this one in particular, is a message from the faith through Jesus of how we are to trek along the straight and narrow path as we serve the Lord Jesus Christ in our daily affairs. Without too much on the introduction, I think it is very imperative that we understand here that as we first look upon Jesus, now late in the evening, the pain is intense. There are no words within the vocabulary of the human frame to articulate or express what the Master is dealing with right now. And I just want to stop right here and remind you here this morning that Jesus paid it all. All to him. Sin had never been to shame, but he lost it right as snow. So whenever you start complaining about what you're going through and what you don't want to do and how you don't want to write and don't want to read and don't want to do whatever the Lord calls you to do, think about the deep, immense pain that your Savior went through. And stop the complaining and put your hands in the gospel plow so that one day when you meet your Savior, you can hear him say, servant, well done. But here, the first thing that we must notice is when Jesus utters these words through these cracked, broken lips and this trembling voice, the word here affirms the humanity of Jesus. Amen. It's a very simple explanation here. We try to get super spiritual and try to do more with the text than the text tells us to do. But simply put, the text is telling you that Jesus was fully human. And our theological reflections over the decades and over the centuries tell us that he was 100% God and 100% man all at the same time. Let me give you one scene that illustrates that to us the best way that I possibly can. Do you remember the 11th chapter of the book of John? Jesus had come to the grave of Lazarus, his best friend. It seemed that it was too late. That body stinketh by now, says one of the sisters. At that 35th verse of the 11th chapter, it says, Jesus wept. Yeah. But then that same Jesus, who had tears flowing down the tracks and the nails of his face, stood up and said, roll the stone away. And he said, Lazarus, come forward. Yeah. Now, I heard one preacher say that he had to say, Lazarus, come forward, because if he had just said, come forth, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, oh my God, and so with the same Jesus that wept is the same Jesus that commanded life over death. And so this great combination is given a summation by saying this: it took a man to weep, but it took a God to speak. The affirmation of his humanity. Let it be said here today that Jesus did not come to tell us how to be divine, but he taught us how to be human under divine auspices. That you ought to understand, and that is, as Jesus says, I thirst. That he shows you that there is a delinquency in the provisions that give him security in his physical life. In other words, Jesus was really suffering physically. And because of the stress of his suffering, because of the tearing up of his body, because of the vexation of his rib cage and his stomach and his head that had already been beaten, Jesus was suffering. There was a delinquency in his physical resources. He was not thirsting for souls. He was not thirsting for the church. He was physically of this country, we were thirsty.
Yeah.
When our bodies were born down under the assault of slavery and then emerging in the Reconstruction era, and then the Ku Klux Klan came along, lynching our forebears, we were thirsty. Yeah. When a bunch of Yale and Harvard law graduates got together in 1896 and said that separate but equal was constitutional, we were thirsty. With some folk down in Michigan, in Flint, Michigan, that is, want to drink a cup of water, and they got mad at it poisoning their children. We are thirsty. When our young black men are on the corner and they are getting beat up because they're wearing beautiful brown skin, we are thirsty. My brothers and sisters, it's time to wake up now and let God be the one who gives us the strength and the heart. But as he comes to the end here, he says, I'm going to take the sponge this time, because even though it was not here by first, I've got something to say. And what he had to say here is what we ought to say, that God is still a good God. He's amazing grace. He's not what we need when we're walking with the God in the shadow of death. He is the light of my salvation. Who shall I fear? Afraid. So clear your throat and give me a praise unto this name.